chapter. Chapter of the New Testament scripture. Praise the Lord. Book number 5 in the New Testament scripture.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Book of Acts, the Acts of the Apostles. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Thank
you. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. The book of Acts, the 18th chapter. Amen. If you don't have a Bible, look on with somebody.
Amen.
Find your Bible and keep the preacher honest. Amen.
Amen.
Acts the 13th chapter. Verse 4 and the 13th chapter of the book of Acts says, so they, being sent forth by the Holy Ghost, departed unto Seleucia, and from there they sailed to Cyprus. When they were at Salamis, they preached the word of God in the synagogues of the Jews. And they had also John to their ministry. And when they had gone through the Isle of Paphos, they found a certain sorcerer, a false prophet, a Jew, whose name was Bar-Jesus, which was with the deputy of the country, Sergius Paulus, a prudent man, who called for Barnabas and Saul, and desired to hear the word of God. But Elymas, the sorcerer, for so is his name by interpretation, withstood them, seeking to turn away the deputy from the faith. And then Saul, who is also called Paul, filled with the Holy Ghost, set his eyes on him and said, "O full of subtlety and all mischief, thou child of the devil, thou enemy of all righteousness, wilt thou not cease to pervert the right ways of the Lord? And behold, the hand of the Lord is upon thee. Thou shalt be blind, not seeing the sun for a season." And immediately there fell on him a mist and darkness. And he went about seeking some to lead him by the hand. And then the deputy, which he saw what was done, believed, being astonished at the doctrine of the Lord. From those words, say that the scripture says in verse 6 or 7 says, Sergius Paulus, a prudent man, called for Barnabas and Saul and desired to hear the word of God. But Elymas, verse 8, the sorcerer, for so is his name by interpretation, withstood them, seeking to turn away the deputy from the faith.
Amen.
Subject, different names, but the same old game. Different names, but the same old game. This text, very interesting text, that gives us great help. And try to understand this thing we call life.
Amen.
How that as we strive to live our own life, the complexity that is involved, the difficulty in just discerning what's right and what's wrong, and what's good and what's bad. We understand, and sometimes we act as if God left no direction.
That's right.
As if God left no instruction. Just saying, whatever feels good, do it. Y'all understand that? Sometimes we live as if God just threw us out here and told us to fend for ourselves. But the reality is, God has a word, and He has a will, and He has a way, and He has a plan for us. That's why the scripture said that. Praise the Lord. There is a way that seems right unto man. Perhaps it even feels right and it looks right. But the end of that way is death and destruction. You must understand that the scripture said that a man's ways always look right in his own eyes. Y'all ain't saying that. We can find a justification for everything that we do. No matter how good or how bad it is, y'all ain't saying nothing. You understand? I took her husband because somebody took mine. Y'all ain't saying nothing. We got a justification for everything that we do. No matter how good or how bad it is, y'all ain't saying nothing. The reality is, God has a will. And if you would seek to do God's will, in looking out His will, you find the scripture says, when a man's ways would please the Lord, that is his character, who you become. When that pleases the Lord, He makes even your enemy to be at peace with you. Now, we understand that God is real, first of all. And not only is God real, but God is our creator. He's our alarm clock, if you will. Y'all understand? It's God that has to wake us up, because if God didn't wake you up, the alarm clock would still ring. Y'all understand? You just wouldn't hear. So it's God that wakes us up. It's God that watches over us overnight. It's God who keeps His loving arms of protection around us. And whatever your situation is right now, it's God that has allowed you to be in your right mind to even know what that is. Praise the Lord. God is worthy. The devil convinces us to sit down on God. Convinces us that God owed us more than what He gave us. You understand? Even though He woke us up, we should have been rich when He woke us up. Y'all understand? The devil would make you think that even though He woke you up, He should have had you set up better than what you were when He woke you up. Rather than thank God for waking me up, because if I got light, I got another chance. I can be better today than I was yesterday. I have an opportunity to get right today. Messed up on yesterday. And I text the Apostle Paul, who was then called Saul. And Barnabas set out on their first missionary journey. And the Bible said that the church had sponsored this journey. Had sent Paul and Barnabas out. But the scripture said that it was the Holy Ghost that led them. It says, separate Paul and Barnabas for the work where I have called them. The Bible says now that when they had left the church and had departed unto Seleucia, there they went to Cyprus. When they got there, they found after preaching in the synagogue. The scripture said they found.